Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Stormblood. I guess we're continuing with the main scenario. Sorry, it's been a few days since I recorded the last episode. Once again, I have let myself go, and I need to record the night that I'm supposed to be posting this. I need to start recording in bulk a lot more often. Let's see here. Ikeda, am I right? I doubt you remember me, but I'll never forget you. Saved my life in Little Al Amigo, you did. Wilrid? And the rest of us had got it into our heads that if we had enough crystals, we would summon Rauger like the Amalja summoned their god. Thankfully, you put a stop to it. Ever hear about what happened to Wilrid? Joined the Braves when they came calling, only to turn up dead one day. Never found out how or why, but I reckon it doesn't matter. Dead's dead, after all. At least he died doing what he thought was right. Maybe that's the best folks like us can hope for, eh? Not that I'm in any hurry, mind. Okay. So, I remember who he's talking about. There was a part in the A Realm Reborn story, I think, where... back in a Little Al Amigo, which is this one camp and a part of Thanalan, there was this guy who was trying to form a group, wanted to summon Rauger, and I had to put a stop to it. Let's see, I say, if it isn't the lad who helped me find the ward I misplaced. But there I go again, treating you as an equal. It wasn't till after you'd gone that one of my comrades pulled me aside and told me it was only the bleeding hero of Eorzea who'd taken time out of his busy day to help me. Well, what is done, but know that I will fight with every ounce of my strength in this coming battle, and the next, and the next. Mayhap that will serve to repay the favor. Fare you well. Okay, well, he's friendly. I just got out of a long recording session of the Surge, making lots of progress tonight. Hopefully I can make a bunch of progress in this. Let's see. Wait, I know you, Lieutenant Komori of the Maelstrom. It is an honor to meet you. I was living hand to mouth in Ulda, but decided to enlist in the Flames after I heard tales of your daring do. And now, as fate would have it, I've been sent here to join in the fight for my home one's liberation. Oh, but this is no time to talk. I've got to prepare for the operation. Take care, Lieutenant. We'll give those Imperial Horsens what for. Pip, pip, cheerio. Okay, get my mount. And go this away. Wonder how long until the next... well, who am I kidding? The next dungeon's probably going to be... wait a second, what level was that dungeon? Dunma Castle, 67. So there's still a 69 dungeon I'm gonna find at some point. And after that, I'll be 70 stuff from there. So you've had a word with the men I mentioned then? Yep. As I'm sure you noticed, they've another thing in common aside from tragedy. You've touched each of their lives in one way or another. They even pointed on the doll where you touched them. But that's not the reason I wanted you to speak with them. A man who's lived in Ghirbani his entire life, who bore witness to the realities of the occupation for 20 unbroken years. A man who fled Al Amigo in search of a new life, who swore to serve another nation only for fate to conspire to send him back here. A youth born on foreign soil who never knew his parents' homeland, yet nevertheless felt kinship with our cause. Three men, three stories, three reasons, yet all belong to the resistance, and growing larger, we've grown more diverse, and while there is good in that, there's also the potential for strife and discord. It'd take a special sort to lead such men to Al Amigo, don't you think? Someone like Lise, you mean? Leader of the Resistance, eh? Don't I have enough titles already? I see we're of one mind. She'll have to make the decision for herself, of course. You've traveled with her, been by her side when she's had to make hard choices. You've seen her at her worst and her best. If you think she's got it in her, then she does. Giggity. Look after her, Ikeda. She's her future and my hope. Okay. I trust I needn't say that this conversation is just between you and me. Mm-hmm. Then I just sneak over to Elise and just tell her everything you just said. Good lad, right then. We'd best head to Castellum Corvi, or what remains of it, rather. Corvi or Corvi? Don't know. It looks like I'm about to have a big fight. Okay, so it's in the fringes. Excuse me. Actually, since the fringes is gonna take forever to travel through, I'll just pause it until I get to where I need to go. Unless a cutscene pops up, then of course I'll unpause it. So be right back really quick, people. I'm back, babies. Close that map. Let's talk to Lise. I said it then, I'll say it again. I won't let it all be for nothing. She's determinated. Let's see. You're the warrior. Yes, it is an honor. I'll prove to them that it wasn't a mistake, that I wasn't a mistake. Her name is Abda. We've known each other since we were small. We'll be going on this mission together. Okay. Either way, let's do this. Let's see. We'll lead the way while the other units launch their own separate attacks. Remember that we need to hold out until Minago sees to the flag. Got your gear in order? Any moment now. Oh, this should be good. And by good, I mean this is gonna hurt.
It's begun then.
That's right, you hugged that griffin.
Good. It's the waiting that drives me mad. Standing around, knowing what's to come. I'll never get used to it.
Calm down, Nago. You're making her nervous. We've come this far, haven't we? We just need to make it the rest of the way.
Wasn't there supposed to be a traitor around here?
Right.
That, like, told them where the resistance is or something. I could have sworn. So derpy.
Looks like the bastards went for the bait. The bridge is ours for the taking. Now remember, Minago, I want you to make for the tower as soon as you see an opening and get that flag flying. We'll see to the fighting.
All right.
I won't let you down, sir.
Come then. Rolga's star shall burn bright this day.
And let the war begin. This should be fun. Doop boop boop doop boop 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 doop. All this loading. Hold on a second. Actually, I guess I can't hold on a second. I was gonna say, hold on a second, but nope. The NPCs just stopped moving on their own. Oh well. Oh god, that's a lot of enemies. Just gonna deal with you.
Here it comes!
Here comes what? Oh wait, that's Lee's talking, I think. Didn't even notice the black mage. You get to die too. I wonder if I can use Dragon Sight on one of these allies. I'll check that out. Just a moment. Alrighty. Easy enough. Sorry, people, it's just hard to keep up with that text during battle, so hopefully you can read it. So, Sentry's General Alden must have his hands full. What was that noise? Oh, wait. When you say I hope Nago's alright, that worries me. I don't need more deaths. And it works. Okay, so I can do this with allies. Oh, crap baskets. I'm just gonna deal with this. Yes, yes, I get it. You don't like me. Unfortunately, I gotta deal with this prick first. Ow! How rude. Okay, you're all kind of swarming me with missiles here. This is not fair. I mean, good lord. First of all, since one of these missiles, like, freaking, you know, auto-launching, haven't seen anything like that in this game yet. Well, you know what I mean, like, cannons that launch themselves. Normally someone has to launch them. Into you. Was that really it? Or is it just a cutscene? What's happening this time? Something's gonna go wrong, and I'm not gonna like it. Oh, crap, it's this lady. Thank you, Clever, with all your little tricks. Think again, none of you are leaving here alive. Alright. The question is, do I kill her? Belongs to the Empire. I'm not about to. Oh Lord, she's using what's his name's moves. Could we not do this? Good. Let's not. Let's just not and say we did. Gunblade. Alright. How about giving me a skill like that? Plan B. Okay. And then... Haha! Not doing as much damage as I thought I was going to do. What's with the fire? Oh, don't want to get knocked into that. What's with the circle around the battlefield? Lady? You want to be a deer and you just get over here. Screw you too. Yeah, I thought that. Okay, I guess you didn't knock me in somehow. That works too.
Meet my new friend!
What new friend? Friends are bad in this game! Oh, great. I don't want to meet your friend. Mother Fluffer. Oh god. This could be an issue. Are you freaking kidding me? Somehow I avoided that. Not quite sure how, but I'll take it. Okay. You are going to have a bad day. Oh no, 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 no. I'd rather take the bleeding than take whatever happens if you fly out of that circle. Chopping block. Good lord, lady, give me a break here. Well, at least she can't knock me out that far. Now the question is, will she die this fight? Or is she only defeated? Looks like she's only defeated. For now. Okay.
God damn you! No more running, no more hiding. Let's finish this.
Ooh. All right. Let's do this.
Look, the flag.
The plane. Hey, lady, you lost your bridge. Bye, bridge. That horn noise is reminding me of Voltron for some reason, like the early episodes.
The bridge is ours! El amigo! El amigo! El amigo!
That was really unnatural. At least animate him when he does that cheer.
Stand your ground! It's not over yet!
Pretty sure it's over.
Damn it!
Oh, come on. Stand your ground. I'm just gonna immediately run away like a coward.
Let them go, Lise. We've done what we came here to do. That's enough for now.
No, it's not. These people are horrible. There's a lot of things we need to do. What the hell? I was about to say, when are the good guys going to start winning? Because they're getting slaughtered right now. How many bodies are you going to throw at them? That seems kind of needless. Oh, that problem is solved. It's not a very intimidating yell. You done screwed up! There goes your base.
Impossible.
Not impossible at all.
We have them on the run! Forward! No mercy!
Yes, please, no mercy. Regroup. Tear them apart.
We have to regroup! All units, fall back!
Still say they need to give him some sort of mechanical arm so he can dual wield again. I don't see why they can't. There is Magitek.
Commander, the fourth cohort has been routed. We'll be at the mercy of the enemy's reinforcements if we don't fall back now.
Idiot! We have the stronger force by far. Don't be taken in by their tricks! Or would you rather tell Xenos you lost to this rabble?
No! But if the snakes betray us in the confusion, we'll have no way out. I'm begging you, Commander. Give the order, or we'll all die here.
As common traitors who drank muddied waters. For all the good it did us.
Oh. Regarding your traitorous ways.
The day is theirs, and so is this bastard bridge. Someone bring the snake.
What snake? Is there gonna be some giant monster snake or something? I don't get it. Or a snake lady. I suppose I haven't found their beastman village yet, so there's probably enemy ones around here.
I suppose. It's our first victory, isn't it? And that has to be worth something.
Yeah, except the Alliance lost a bunch of people. Faceless people, but still people. Alright, Minago. For a moment there, I didn't think I could do it, but then I did! Compelling words, really. The words some of these NPCs say. Okay, so you're indeed everything they see. This is Theft of Legends. Did you see that Abba Ollie? We did it. Who's Abba and Ollie? Dead people? Well fought, brothers and sisters. Today is a day that will be remembered for generations to come. Okay, it's a shame Fordolo got away, but we did what we came here to do. I have to remind myself it's just the first step, but it's a big one. We're going to take it back, all of it, one helm at a time if we have to. Yeah, until something goes horribly wrong with the sadistic prick, but like they want to do. See, there's still a chance that some Imperials are holed up inside the castellum. We'll need to search it top to bottom to be sure it's safe. In the meantime, I want you to rendezvous with the main host. Keep your weapons at the ready. There's a chance you might come face to face with soldiers on the run en route. Okay. On second thought, it might be prudent for you to do a preemptive sweep of the region of soldiers that have gone to ground. We shouldn't afford them any time to regroup and launch a counterattack. When you've judged your work to be done, report to General Alden in Bittermill. Okay. God, whenever I hear that name, Bittermill, it makes me think of WoW. For some reason. Now then. Just need to... What the hell? Is there like a... Oh. Yeah, it's Antlion's burrowing. Oh, they're breathing down there? That's kind of freaky. Ugh, I forgot how nasty these things' faces looked. Alright. Take you down. You got a lot of HP for some reason. Oh, you're a tank, I suppose, but still. You know, that's the sad thing, is Dragoon was the main class when it came to the story of Heaven's Word. But it feels like we're getting much better abilities here than they did in Heaven's Word. Funnily enough. Compared to Monk, Monk got screwed over entirely when it comes to their skills. I mean, nothing cool. It's just a bunch of buffs. Buffs and slight differences to already existing skills, and that's pretty much it. Feels like the expansions were swapped slightly. Alright, go to you. Wait, there's two of you this time. Hope the HP is different. Otherwise you'll be a pain to deal with. Alright. I see who I'm killing first. How the bloody fluff muffins did I get stunned? Paralyzed, I mean. Oh no. Oh no. Now die. Thank you. Oh, okay. For a second I thought I was gonna have to go all the way back there, but apparently not. Guess it makes sense, it's Castromorians. Horse, horse. Really? What kind of name is that? Alright, generals. What do you have for me? Oh, these two are here too. They're begging for mercy at this point. It's not happening. See, the Bull of Alamigo has done it again. His assessment of Fordola's response was without error. It's a good thing Monago got the flag flying when she did. Any longer, those Imperials might have had us at their mercy. Well, Matt, all's well at the bridge. Good, good. The fighting has died down here, too, as you can see. Pippin left but a moment ago with a contingent of troops to occupy Veladina. If and when the Imperials return, they'll find us dug in behind their own walls. I could not have hoped for a better outcome, General. Splendidly done. Let's not get ahead of ourselves. It'll take more than one Castellan to turn the tide. My men and I will deal with the remaining enemy forces. Scions, I bid you return to Commander Kemp and his men. Okay. Delight not over much in victory, not when there are battles left to fight. Our work here is finished. Our resistance allies are waiting. Alrighty. It'll take a few minutes. Well, it'll take like a minute or two to get there anyway, so I'll just pause it. Be right back, people. I'm back, babies. Alright, let's see here. Let's see. If you're looking for Ehrenwald, I think he's with Pippin, searching the Castellum for any remaining soldiers. Now that we have taken control of Veladina, there's nothing stopping us from marching east towards the peaks. From a stone bridge to a massive fortress, Garlean engineering never ceases to impress. See, back so soon, I suppose the general and his men had matters well in hand. The vice marshal and his men showed up not long after you left. If the gods are good, there will be no one left to fight. Now, you know things never go that easily. I know you're not one for waiting, but you'll bear with it. But if you'll bear with us... Commander Kemp, Marshal Tarupin reports that their sweep of the Castellum's interior has been completed. So it's finally over, eh? Pray extend to him my deepest thanks. It's official then, Castellum Veladina is well and truly ours. Mayhap this calls for a wait. Where's Monago? She took her bird and flew off towards the Peering Stones, the village of the M tribe. Where she was born. I doubt that the Imperials who fled Veladina had a mind to give them trouble on their way back east, but she was nevertheless worried, so I gave her leave to go and see that her people were safe. Oh no. So I pray you are right. It would be best if Monago were not alone if she should encounter the enemy. Agreed. Let's all go to the Peering Stones and make sure that everything is alright. I've got a bad feeling about this. If that's your wish, then I have no objection. Just let the guard know when you wish to cross. I have a really bad feeling about this. I hope I'm wrong. But this game has screwed me over so many times. I don't trust it! I don't trust it! See, greetings, Scion. Do you wish to pass? Of course. was mindlessly easy. Alright. Ooh. Metal Fortress. Fancy. And a completely nonsensical dead end. Alright. Why? If this were a Dark Souls game, there'd be an item there at least, but really? It's kind of just bad architecture. Alright, what do these fools gotta say? Since when did you become a bloodhound, a Makote ought to trust their ears, not their nose. Sniff, sniff, on your guard, Ironvald, they're still about. Oh no. Let's see, did you say you were for the Peering Stones? In that case, mayhap Marshal Tarrapin and I should join you. We spied a suspicious pair earlier, Ahir and Alalafel, by the looks of them, but they fled when they realized they've been spotted. If they're Imperials, then we can't have them stirring up trouble. Alright. Sleeping Curl. This was simply called Veladina Bridge. Before the Garleans arrived, they saw it fit to transform it into a base for their supply trains. What's more, atop this tower, they could survey the area for miles around. Their ambition knows no bounds, nor does their villainy. Okay. We'll soon start sending scouts east to survey the land in preparation for our advance. We do not anticipate much resistance at this time, but should we encounter any Imperial forces, we shall deal with them quickly and severely. Alrighty. Freaking Chubby Chocobo. Finally some new land! And maybe I can... Actually, yeah, it's not even a maybe. I can finally get my freaking Aether Currents here. And bloody... freaking... be able to fly. So that'll save a lot of trouble here. Just a few more Aether Currents. Hopefully. Tracker Antlion. Is that over there on fire? I guess some remnants of a ship. Okay, 235 yams to the southeast. God dang it. Freaking poofball. Alright, let me just go to this village. Freaky looking gazelle. Okay, so who's over here? Alphalese, Alisei, and Alphino. Alright. See, but of course, tiring though it may be to come and go from the cliff top, it is easily defended and affords an excellent view of the surrounding area. What? This area is home to dangerous beasts, not that we cannot handle. Mind, but do not be surprised if something ravenous and slavering comes charging at you out of nowhere. The path to the village is through a tunnel just east of here. Follow me! Alright. What tunnel? I see no tunnel. Wait, what in the world was that? Weird visual effect that happened. There was like a blur. Okay, to the north. I'll go there soon enough. Telesaris. M-Tribe Ranger! Do, doodly doo doo doo. Finally a new village and a new area. It's about bloody time. Yeah, it's a Makote village. Kitty people! Okay, come on, come on, we're almost there. What do you mean we're almost there? We're right here! You're already there, you dingbat.
Ah, you've come. Welcome, friends, to my village. My home.
A really small home.
How fare your people?
Good, all things considered. Better than the Ananta at any rate. They've sent an emissary. I'll take you to her.
All right.
We're here to help. Will you tell us what happened?
Aye. It began with a quarrel between the Imperials and the Kalyana.
Okay. Tell us, Snake Lady.
The Kalyana are another Ananta tribe. The strongest and the most influential.
And probably the evil Unlike ones that I have to kill.
They want no part of our troubles. They swore fealty to the Empire and were content to remain within their borders.
Of course they were.
Just so. The Kalyana forsook their pride in the fight and yielded to Garlemald long ago.
Sounds like a bunch of dirty cowards. And I'm guessing they're also the ones that have the other
but
primal.
But when a new commander was sent to hold the Black Bridge, she demanded the Kalyana surrender a hostage, this butcher.
Poor Dola. It doesn't make sense, though. The Vera are the ones working with the Resistance. Why would she threaten the Kalyana?
Because she is ignorant, like all Imperials. She knows not the difference between Kalyana and Vera, nor does she care to learn.
Mm-hmm. I see. All Fedola knew for sure was that the Resistance would come from the west. She reasoned, therefore, that if the Ananta on the east bank turned their coats, she would be trapped. I take it the Kalyana had no choice but to oblige her.
Well, they could have just killed her.
No, they did not. The Imperials left with the Kalyana broodmother's own daughter, Anamika.
I stand corrected.
Long days and nights she looked out on the Black Bridge weeping for her child. Until you came.
Oh, never mind, I guess they're the good ones.
The broodmother knew at once which way the winds would blow. She and her warriors met with the fleeing Imperials in the road and demanded that her daughter be returned.
Let me guess, they were killed, weren't they?
Fordola's not the kind to take threats lying down.
You know her well. The butcher turned her blade to Anamika and bade the Kalyana move aside. But the brood mother would not yield.
I know where this is going.
Oh no. This isn't gonna go well at all. Yep.
The Kalyana surrounded the Imperials, one of whom, whether out of fear or stupidity, cut the child down. There was naught that could be done.
I hope they slaughtered her for that. Well, slaughtered those three for that.
The true madness was yet to come. For in her despair, the Kalyana broodmother cried out for her daughter to be restored to life. She beseeched Sri Lakshmi's intercession.
And that's the other primal.
She summoned a primal then and there?
Please tell me the primal killed that witch.
That she did, if only for an instant. Bereft of courage and honor, the broodmother sought solace in her faith. The Imperials fled in terror at the sight of the goddess, abandoning these lands to the Ananta.
Okay.
Now the Kalyana bid us make pilgrimage to pay proper respects. Yet though we Vera revere Sri Lakshmi as the holiest of the holy, we will not prostrate ourselves before her.
Yep, so they're the evil ones I'll have to kill. Joy.
Aye. All who have fought with the Resistance have heard tell of the warrior, the Icon Slayer.
And that would be me. Of course they all look at me. It's like, why do I have to do this? Every time. Always with the gods.
I believe we have heard enough. Inconvenient though the timing may be, If a primal has indeed been summoned, we can scarce afford to ignore it. We must needs discuss how best to resolve this situation.
It's going to be such a pain. I mean, if freaking Susano's any indication. He was already a pain. Rather big one. Materia. Material will never do me wrong. It'll do me in just the right places. Alright, let's see. This is all Fedora's fault. Okay. Still can't believe that a primal's been summoned so close to the village. The idea that our people could be taken to serve as thralls is... it just doesn't bear thinking about. Let's see, if slain many icons before, yes, then please put an end to this madness. And now we have a primal to contend with as well. As if the Empire needed an excuse to start rounding up beastmen again. Okay. Ahem, at the risk of sounding helplessly naive, there may yet be a way to avoid a violent confrontation. You know that's not going to work. In the past, I fear I've been rather too willing to accept that we have no other recourse than to risk our lives, or rather your life, to address these threats. Yet the primals we have faced thus far have demonstrated a variety of temperaments and objectives. Ravana may delight in battle, but Rama would sooner keep to the forest with his children. Ere we decide to challenge Sri Lakshmi, it would seem wise to learn more of her nature from those who summoned her unto this world. If that is your will, then so be it. To the north, you will find our village. Sarisha shall unfold all. We shall leave at once. Minago, can you inform our comrades at the bridge of what happened? Of course. Be safe, my friends. This is gonna be a pain in the butt. Let's see, well met, traveler. Might I interest you in a Chocobo Porter? Nope, just unlocking you. Oh. Alright, I'll take this quest then. Since I kind of have to. See, oh sorry, I was distracted by the grumbling of my tummy. Thanks to the Garlians, we've been having trouble maintaining our food stores. Custom dictates that any game brought back to the village must be distributed evenly amongst everyone, but there hasn't been much to go around lately. Without fear of harassment from the Garlians, we can finally begin hunting again, but there's still much to do if we're going to replenish our supplies. Any chance you'd be willing to help? If you could bring back, say, 3 Teleoceruses, it would be a great help, because you're going to eat a bunch of rhino dinosaurs. Okay, you'll find them to the north of here, but don't kill them. We'll need their meat to be as fresh as possible when it's put away. When you've worn them down enough, you can stuff them into these bags without much of a fight. How can you stuff them into bags? They're gigantic! Now, I know what you're thinking, but trust me, they'll fit. Stay out, stay safe out there. You're out of your freaking mind. They know that sounds ridiculous. They know full well that sounds freaking ridiculous that I'm going to be putting dinosaurs into bags and carrying them around. This is stupid. What the hell? But alright, whatever. Let's see, well, Abby, you're the adventurer from Castel and Veladina, aren't you? Put on quite a show down there. I'm sure you hear this all the time, but we could really use a man of your talents right about now. Dahars have been cropping up to the south of here, and they've been giving us no small amount of trouble. We do what we can to keep them at bay, but every once in a while we'll come across a mountainous mess of gold-dusted rock that sends us running with our tails between our legs. I imagine handling a few Dahars would be like swatting flies for you. If you go and tear down a few Daharas, one of those golden monstrosities is bound to show up. Toppling even one would go a long way to helping us take back our hunting grounds. Okay. So I'm helping a bunch of kitty people now. Alrighty, I'll take it. Where is... is there an Aether Current up here? To the south. Well, crap. I'm gonna grab that south Aether Current first. Just cause, I mean, it's right there. Probably right over there, actually. And And there goes my legs. Please don't aggro me. Please don't aggro me. Please don't aggro me. I said, don't aggro me. You are disobeying. That's new. What the hell? Sorry, people normally wouldn't stop to do this, but this is a new fate. Maybe it's an achievement fate. It looks like it would be an achievement fate. Well, nah, it's definitely not strong enough to be an achievement fate, but still. I need the XP anyways. Okay, do that. I'll do this. You weren't supposed to turn around, mate. And kaboom. Alright. Oh wait, I could be wrong. You may actually be a problem. You're actually taking a while to kill. Person over there, you want to heal me? Be a deer. Be a deer and heal me, please. You're not healing me. Please. Please heal me. Health. Health is good. Health is your friend. Health is love. Health is life. I'm gonna summon my chicken now! Heal a chicken. 1-800-CALL-CHICKEN. Heal me quicker, please. Chicken, you have one job. I order you to heal me. My chicken's not healing me enough. This is worrying. Oh my god, Becky. Look at her butt. Okay. Thankfully, the red mage was like, oh right, I can heal. Thanks for that. I'm curious as to why Dragoon's having to tank this fight, but oh well. This better be an achievement fate. Let's see, once again, warriors of the M tribe hunt the Scourge of the Skies, the feathered fiend White Death. The warriors hunt Birda and welcome any who might seek to share in their glory. Okay, so this, it sounds like it'd be an important fate. Poison on you. And then kaboom. I need to start doing Gerskolo more often. Such a useful attack. Oh right, I forgot, whenever I do level up, I'm gonna get a new ability. I'm not sure what ability it is, but it better be good. Oh, there's actually a tank class right there, but for some reason they can't steal the hate from me. Or they're not trying. And that wasn't even an achievement fate. I'm sorry, people. It looked like it'd be an achievement fate. I guess I'll just have to settle for killing this. Actually, wait, where's the bloody thing? To the east. Okay, so it is this way. Alright, that's fine. Hopefully it's up here, next to these freaking Daharas. These freaky things. Chicken? Why do you go the weird direction? Let me just give it a map. I don't know why. Half the time I open the map without even realizing it, and I just leave it on for some reason. It annoys me too, believe me. kindly die. Thank you. There's the aether current I'm looking for. Slay Highland Daharas and then defeat the Gold Dust Dahara when it appears. Alright. Oh, this is gonna be a pain. But the sooner I get these freaking aether currents, the better. Oh, right. I keep forgetting about freaking Gerskogel. I don't even know if I'm pronouncing that right. But as far as I know, it is. And again, it's also some weird name that's in a different language. So there's no way to tell. Alright. Wait, so that wasn't even enough? Screw you too, mate. I thought you said I only needed to kill like two or three of those things, and then the gold one would appear. It's like, nope. You prick. Alright, let's see about this aether current. 268 to the east. Alright. Now, if you would kindly spawn the thing I need to kill, that would be great. Thank you kindly. I'm just gonna go full out on this one. Okay, so do this, 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 lay this. I went and did the wrong move because I'm a dummy. Oh well. Basically, I meant to use that for my third attack because that's pretty strong, but nope, I'm a derp. Another one of those things over here. Hopefully, in a place I can reach. To the east. I'm going to. Actually, I'm going to pause it. I'll be right back, people. Okay, found the other aether current over here. That's great. How many am I short, anyways, for this area? Mounts. Nope, nope, not that. Intercurrents. This is the fringes. So. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, no. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so I just need two more ones that I can find on foot, and then the rest will come from side quests. I will be right back again. Nope, I'm back. Nah, just to kill these things. It should only take a moment. Actually, I'm probably gonna put my chicken in free stance, that way it can attack and heal. You better be a good chicken. You beat up these dinosaurs. Oh, wait. I need to somehow beat this thing in a bag. So stupid. How in the hell? It's so stupid. Freaking game mechanics. Okay, that should be enough. Into the sack with you. And then you be joining them soon. And into the sack with you. Oh, you good weakened sack thingy. Who's trapped in the sack? You are. That's who. Okay, Aether Current. Northwest. I'll be right back again. Found another Aether Current. Just grabbing it here. Be right back again. Alright, I'm back again. Gotta turn in these little side quests really quick. So you're back! Do those bags contain what I think they do? Yes, I've got your freaking dinosaur-filled sack. Perhaps better not to ask how a 10-ton dinosaur could fit into this sack. Yeah. Wow, you really did it. Not that I didn't think you could, mind you. It's just been so long since anyone here's had the guts to contend with those beasts. By the way, gotta point out the fact. It just said my character is strong enough to carry 30 tons. I mean, seriously? And yet I couldn't hold up the freaking roof! Come on! You can be sure we'll make good use of them. Their meat for rations is a given, but their horns and bones will make good tools, and their hides can make belts and boots. You know, the Teleoceras isn't even native to these lands. The Garlands used them for carrying freights, but the Sods couldn't keep them under control. A few of them escaped into the wild, started breeding, and here we are. I guess you could say it's a blessing in disguise if they hadn't brought Teleoceras here. We'd have one less source of meat and materials for fashioning our tools. But seriously. So my character is strong enough to hold up 30 tons. I carry 30 tons. And yet I couldn't help freaking Gosetsu lift that roof. That is so insulting to my intelligence. Everyone should be angry about that. Let's see, no need to explain. I saw the whole thing from here. You were every bit as amazing as I had hoped. A shame those things are like to come back for after a while. People say they're born from the spirits of warriors who have fallen in battle. Personally, I think it has something to do with the Aether around here, but I've been praying for an end to the war all the same. Take care, friend. I'll be cheering for you. Okay. And thankfully, those are the only side quests here for now. I guess I will be right back as I head toward the main scenario. So I'll be right back just a second, people. Alright, I'm back. Time to talk to Miss Snake Lady. See, we do not often receive guests. What is the purpose of your visit? Greetings and well met. We are the Scions of the Seventh Dawn. We come seeking Sarisha of the Vera. You are she, are you not? You have petitioned us for aid and succor, and we intend to provide them, but we would first learn more of Shri Lakshmi, that we might better understand the nature of the threat she poses to you. A simple request, and one which I shall gladly oblige. In the beginning was Shri Lakshmi. We were created in her image, daughters blessed with her beauty. Her breath became ours, her serenity our solace. There is naught she would not give. Twas the Kalyana, Broodmother's desire to bring about her daughter's resurrection, which first called forth Sri Lakshmi from the Aether. That being the case, I rather doubt the goddess will be spoiling for a fight. That will depend. The primal's motives will have been colored by the summoner's state of mind, namely that of a grieving mother who had just borne witness to her daughter's murder. Though she apparently craved a miracle, she may have also harbored thoughts of vengeance. Moreover, the Kalyana's conception of Sri Lakshmi may differ from that of the Avira. This is true. The Avira and the Kalyana do indeed regard the Lady of Bliss in different ways. To the Viras, Sri Lakshmi embodies freedom. She would not suffer her daughters to be bound to another's will, and so we stand with the resistance against the Empire and give our lives for the cause. To the Kalyana, however, she embodies transcendental beauty, which they strive to create through their craft. The shaped crystal is less art and more ritual, a sacred duty wherein each tribute is imbued with a fragment of the soul. The Imperials do not interfere with this holy work, and so the Kalyana were content to turn inward and ignore our plight, until reality asserted itself and they summoned a primal, a fever dream to soothe their aching hearts. But surely they can see that it won't do any good. The Imperials will still rule these lands, nothing will change. The Ananta will. The Kalyana bade the Vera make pilgrimage to pay proper respects, remember? Those who do not wish to partake of their primal's bliss will be made to do so. Not while we're around, they won't. Though our beliefs are not the same, we are still kin to the Kalyana. We help them see to see reason. Know that I'll kill your god if I have to, maybe even if I don't. I don't want to say that. That sounds really bad, but at the same time, it sounds funny. No, this does go with the lame response. Then we shall, for without you, we may be the powerless to stop them. If we do not act quickly, more lives will be lost, more families torn apart, more children made to suffer. Then it's settled. We're going to find that primal pun into this. My sister Vajra will guide you to Dahana Khat, and I'll pray for your success. Okay. Okay, let's talk to this lady. See, well met, Saiyans. I am Vajra, she who shines bright and unbroken. I stand ready. We leave upon your command. Give me my materia. Thank you, lady. And leveled up to 68. Mirage Dive. This should be good. Delivers an attack with a potency of 200. Can only be executed when dive ready. What creates the dive ready effect? I'm curious. Grants dive ready. Oh, so anytime I use those jumps, it gives me dive ready. So it's like a chain of jump attacks. That's actually pretty freaking cool. Hell yeah. I'll take that. So now I can do 4 jumps. And, well, actually 5 jumps, technically. That's freaking cool. See, I'm not sure why Alice is so eager to face this primal all of a sudden, but you won't hear me complaining. Let's see, we were too late for him in Limsa, but this time. Too late for who? Let's see, I'm reminded of the tragedy we bore witness to beneath Ogamoro, when poor Gabu cried out in despair and rage, and Titan came forth in answer. Oh, right, there was an earlier story. I think it was in Heaven's Word, where this kid, it was a kobold, and he witnessed his parents get murdered, and he ended up summoning a different version of Titan. So yeah, that happened. But anyways, I'm gonna end this episode here. In the next episode, I guess I'm gonna fight a god again! That should be fun, right? So if you lovely people enjoyed this, leave a like and subscribe, leave a comment, possibly leave a donation, share the channel with your friends, poke the notification button. And if you'd like to support my channel and help it grow, maybe visit my Patreon and become a patron. And I'll see you lovely people in the next episode. Have a good night, everybody!